to best friend. How are you today?
I'm great.
What are you ready for?
I'm ready for another show.
Another show of what?
Tough Girls and Heroes.
Yeah, Tough Girls and Heroes. Let's get right into it. I'm going to share a screen. I can't wait for our guest today. Here we go. Say it. You are on fire, kid. Tell us who our special guest is today. It's very exciting. Go ahead.
Coach Chelsea Walkland.
Yeah.
Assistant coach for Colgate University.
Yeah, women's hockey. Can't even wait. Tell us about Coach.
She's from Pittsburgh, New York, had a bachelor's degree in business administration and also a master's degree in instructional leadership.
Wow.
Former college hockey player and two-year captain at Robert Morris.
Yep.
Played in a program record 140 games.
Wow.
Former assistant coach at RIT, 28-1-1 record and Division III national champions.
Wow, so she was there 1 year and they won the national championship? It's unbelievable. What'd she do the next years?
USA Hockey, New York State District Evaluator.
Mm-hmm.
Coach at Oswego, broke school record for wins 2 years in a row, 2013 and 2014.
Oh.
Assistant coach at Robert Morris, 2015 to 2018. Three-time defending College Hockey America regular season champs.
Wow, nice.
NCAA Final Eight appearance. Colgate assistant coach 2019 present.
That's a lot. That's an impressive resume. What do you think? Should we let Coach in?
Yeah.
All right. And then I'm going to let you take it away. That was a very, very nice intro.
Hey, hey.
You just got a great intro. Brenster, take it away.
Hi, Coach. How are you? Any questions?
Yeah, excited for the questions. Thanks for having me on, Bren.
You're welcome.
You ready, Brenster, for the question?
Yeah. My first question is, what made you want to play hockey as a kid and keep going?
Good question. I grew up playing a handful of different sports like you, Bren. So you play lots of different sports, right?
Yeah.
Yep. So I played some different sports, and I actually didn't start playing hockey until I was either 9 or 10. And the reason that I got into playing ice hockey was something that's coming up soon, the Olympics, the 1998 Women's Olympic hockey team was something that I got to watch. The women's hockey was in the Olympics for the first time in that year. And I know one of your former guests on here, Coach King, was on that team. So I actually grew up and I watched that, and a lot of my buddies that I grew up playing just outside with in the neighborhood, they all played. They were all guys that played, and I didn't really know that girls played until my eyes were kind of opened at that Olympics. And you know, after I saw that, I asked my parents if I could play, and they said yes, and I fell in love with it, and the rest is history after that.
Hey, think of that, Brian. You had Coach King on from Boston College, and she talked about the Olympics. And that's when Coach really got inspired to play. I think 98 and 99 for women was a really big couple year span with hockey and soccer. That really inspired a lot of women in our country.
Absolutely. The 99 soccer, that was huge. Big part of my upbringing. I grew up in Rochester, New York there, and they started a girls program shortly after that. So that's how I got started into it. And thankful for all those players that paved the way kind of for future generations.
Friends, how'd you get started in hockey?
Yeah.
What'd you start doing?
I forgot.
How'd you start skating? What did you didn't just start playing hockey. You did what?
Roller skated.
You were doing that. You rollerbladed, and then you were doing learn to skate, right? You had to learn to skate first, right?
There you go. How old were you?
Four.
Yeah.
Nice.
A lot of times when I was walking on the ice, I needed like a helper with me because I was just like walking on the ice. I wasn't even skating.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Yeah, I've got three little kids. I got a 4-year-old, a 2-year-old, and a 4-month-old. And the 4-year-old skates, and the 2-year-old, he's kind of just walking like you were doing, Brent. He's just kind of feeling it out and kind of getting his balance going and all that. So
I remember those days, and it was a while ago, but I remember that first couple of sessions, you couldn't even get up once you fell. That was like a big deal. Is finally being able to stand up. I remember that.
Huge accomplishment there.
Oh, yeah. What's your second question, Red? What do you got?
Second question is, how did it feel to win a national championship at RIT as a coach?
Awesome. It was a really cool experience. Great question. Growing up in Rochester, it was really cool. Lots of my family and friends were around. But that was actually my first year ever of coaching, too. So right after I was done playing, I got right into to coaching, and to have an opportunity to be a part of just kind of a journey of winning a national championship. I've learned so much throughout that year, and after winning that in the first year, and then now having coached a little bit over 10, 11 years or so now, you realize how special those years are. That you can go all the way. I haven't won a national championship since, hoping to keep kind of chipping away at that, but it makes you appreciate, how special our group was and how great the coaching staff prior to me, bringing in just great, great players, great people. We had a great leadership core. So, it was an awesome thing to be a part of, and got a little taste of winning and what that feels like. And so you kind of get that hunger to keep going and keep feeling that again.
Cool.
Brent, you ever been to some RIT games?
Yeah.
You've been to a few?
Loud music.
Loud music? Oh, yeah.
What else do you like? Who do you like giving five to when you're at the games?
RIT Tiger.
Yeah, you do. We got some good pictures, especially when you were younger with the RIT.
There you go. I grew up going to those games too.
Yeah.
Really. I still have the bobblehead over there.
You do have the bobblehead. Go ahead and grab it. You can show Coach. Go ahead.
Yeah, let's see that thing.
You got an RIT bobblehead right there. all the rest of her stuff, quote unquote.
Yeah, all kinds of stuff back there.
Oh yeah. Trust me. Watch everything come crashing down.
That'd be some good content for the podcast. Yeah,
that would be great. Uh-oh. What do you got, Red? Did the head fall off of the bobblehead? Did you lose the head? All right, just show the body then, Brent.
No, I didn't.
Coach, if this were more than a one-take show, we might edit a little bit of this, but we've never edited one show between her and her brother over a year and several months.
Can't start now. There it is.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It's a good memorabilia minute right there.
Yeah, there you go. I think
that'll be a memorabilia minute today. Brenz, what's your next question?
It was, was, what was it like being a captain in college, and what was the toughest part of being a leader?
Yeah, it was really cool. It's a special honor, you know, anytime you're named captain. And, you know, for me, I was named actually halfway through my junior year. And anytime you're voted, like a lot of times it's different how it's done, but, for us, it was, my teammates voted and the coaching staff like voted to and so, yeah, like anytime that happens and you've got that, the support of your peers and, everything like that, it's just a huge honor. And so it was really special to be a captain. And, you know, I think a lot of people, you know, like the idea of being a captain and think about it, but there's a lot that goes into it. And, you know, I think, one of the toughest things I found, probably two things, if I can answer two things, Brenz, I know we'll add on to that there, but, I think the first thing is as a leader of a team, like you're always on, and it's not just being a leader on the ice. It's in your everyday, it's, you know, in the weight room, it's, you know, going to team meal with your teammates and just making sure that you're doing the right things all the time. I think that's one of the things that you're always kind of trying to keep note of. And then I think the second part is, sometimes getting out of your comfort zone a little bit as a leader. Yeah. Like for me, I was always kind of the lead by example, like working hard type thing. And, you know, speaking up, like that wasn't always my, you know, my comfort zone. And, you know, sometimes as a leader, you got to get outside that comfort zone and, you know, maybe do things that you're not totally comfortable with. So, I have found that as a challenge, but at the end of the day, you just want to make sure you're doing everything you possibly can, for the team, at the end of the day and making decisions. And again, like I said, getting out of your comfort zone just to try and help the team.
Really work on leadership and leadership qualities with both her and her brother, and been having some really good feedback. Brent, you want to talk about you stepping up yesterday at school and what was happening in your group and how you were a leader? I'm really proud of you doing that. This is some of what Coach is talking about and speaking up. So what happened? Tell Coach.
Someone just wasn't letting some of us share ideas for a craft. And told my teacher, and she was like, I forgot what she said, but then we all shared ideas and we ended up winning the little craft.
So once everyone put their ideas in, that kind of helped you collaborate and get to the winning one. Yeah.
She realized when she came home yesterday, you said that one person doesn't have all the answers, right, Red? And that everyone probably had some good ideas, and you went and talked to your teacher about one person who was the opposite gender, and you stuck up for yourself and your group and made sure that everyone was sharing ideas, right? And then you guys built the tallest tower. They actually won because they collaborated. So I was real proud of hearing that from you yesterday. And I know,
it must have been really, really, sturdy, because, when we were, some people were playing catch, and then it, the ball went up and hit it, and only a couple fell down.
That's good. You guys did a nice job, but you're learning because you also have another time where you had to stick up for yourself, being the only girl in the group too this year. So she's used to it, but these are all things that Coach was just talking about with leadership.
Yeah.
I'm glad that, you know, you're going to go back and listen to what Coach said and keep working on these things. Brenz, do you have, the magic eight ball ready?
My wild card, remember?
Yeah. The wild card question. This is why, you know what? This is why you run your everything.
She's got it. Right,
go ahead, kid. Wild card. You're a veteran, friends. Go ahead.
The wild card question is, what is your favorite memory of, as a child?
You know what? Great question. And we talked a little bit about it early on here, something that, that you and your family do as well. But building an outdoor hockey rink in our backyard. That's something that our family did together. And the best part was when you got a snow day, you could stay at home and shovel off the rink back there and just spend time together as a family and get that extra work. I think that's probably one that sticks out the most. Keep making memories out there.
Yeah.
We did yesterday, didn't we?
Yeah.
You had to beat, what was your time you had to beat? You wouldn't come in and take.
I had to beat, I came up with these two drills. One was like a one-on-one, kind of like a race. The other one was like an obstacle course. So for the backhand one, we got to weave through the cones and do a circle at the top and then come down and shoot.
Okay.
And then the forehand was 11 point something.
Yeah.
And then that was my record.
Nice.
I broke it, so it was my record then. And then the backhand was 11.76.
Okay.
77.
77. And then you wouldn't go inside until you broke it because you couldn't let your brother have that satisfaction of having the top score.
Then when I shot it, it was 11.9.
Yep, and then she kept going.
Love it. Were you out there till dark? Do you have lights out on the rink there?
Yeah, we bring them out. They're big lights.
Nice. I like that. You stuck to it till you got that record.
Yeah, I was proud of her. We got a good little system out there. We got the big floodlights from camping that we just hang on the trees. We've got a little woods area, so...
Nice.
That's how we work it at nighttime. So
love it.
I'm glad you remembered the wild card question. I feel bad that I forgot, but this is, you should remember. What's next, Redster? All right. Coach can ask if she wants to ask any questions, a yes or no. You're going to shake it up.
Okay. Again, we'll keep the Olympics theme going. Ooh. How about Will USA women's hockey win the gold?
Will USA women's hockey win the gold?
Or shake that thing up good.
Come on.
Sonora.
Yes, definitely.
Hey! Woo! Where's your USA hockey hat? Point to that. We just scared the dog. I heard her barking. Where's your USA hockey hat? Point to it. There it is.
Very good. All right, you have to wear that
North Carolina practice jersey. Awesome.
It's the sparkly thing back there.
Yeah, I like it. Coach, one question for me, if you don't mind.
Sure.
Because we ran out of questions, and this is Tough Girls and Heroes. A time in your life you had to be really tough, or the toughest.
Yeah. Well, I'm a parent now, so I feel like some days that can be tough, but I don't know. Like, I think, just kind of bringing it back, like along with the theme of kind of what we've been talking about, you know, in terms of growing up, like I played different sports on teams with boys and girls. And then, so like as an athlete, and then now as a coach, you know, I coach women's hockey, but it's coaching at one time was typically a male dominated sport. And, so I think as both an athlete and as a coach, I've had moments where, you know, maybe like the instance that you had in your classroom there, Bren, where, you know, sticking up for yourself and being confident and being proud of your ideas, you know, and maybe in a situation where you're outnumbered. So I think that's probably it kind of throughout my life. Cause I've seen, you know, from different perspectives as like an athlete and as my career and things like that. And I think at the end of the day, Bren's like, you want to be confident in what you do and your voice matters like it did when you were creating your project there. And yeah, so I think that's probably my answer. In the long short of it. So staying confident in yourself and believing in yourself, even when it's hard, even when you are outnumbered.
You've had that situation happen. Coach, thank you for such an awesome answer, because this really relates to another situation she had where she was the only girl in her group at school and everyone voted against her to be team leader. And she didn't like it. And she's like, well, why can't I be team leader?
Right.
I've got a lot of good ideas. Right, Red?
Yeah.
And we talked about it and I was like, I'm proud of you. I said, what's going to happen next time that happens? And you said you're going to make sure that what?
I was team leader.
That's right, girl. I love it.
Let's go.
That's right. Let's go, Brenster. So, well, Coach, I know you got a busy schedule. Thank you for joining us. I'll let Ben say your thank yous and goodbyes. And again, thank you for taking the time. This was awesome. We got a lot of great stuff.
Awesome. Yeah, thank you.
Brent, take it away.
Oh, lights out. Good timing there.
Oh, there you go.
My sensor light. Sorry.
Thanks for being on my show.
Thanks so much for having me, Brenz. You keep it up, okay?
Okay.
Good luck.
Good luck with the season, Coach. Maybe we'll see you sometime.
Sounds great. I love that.
All right. Take care.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
All that stuff that she talked about, very similar to some of the things that are happening in your life. Would you agree? I would agree 100%. Oh, you got your RIT bobblehead. I can see it. Show that again. Show that little bobblehead. He's cute. All right, let's just sign off. Let's just sign off today. This was just a fantastic show with Coach. Thanks to her, and good luck to Colgate women's hockey in their upcoming games and going into the playoffs. All right, Brent, sign it off. Two things, hit it.
And remember, stay tough, and if you can dream it, you can achieve it.
Yeah. Love you, kid. Great show. We'll see you later.